everyone, Chris from Macombo here, and I'm here with the brand new shiny Honor 6A budget handset. It's just been launched here in the UK. It'll be available from the tail end of July 2017 for £150. And we've also got the Honor 6X, which of course is already available. It came out at the very start of the year, and this originally came out for around the £200 mark and can be found for a little bit less these days. If you're lucky, you can pick it up for around 150 quid as well, if you know where to look and you find it on offer. So we're just going to do a quick side-by-side to sort of see what the difference is and which one might be best for you. So as you can see, obviously the Honor 6A is a much more compact handset than the 6X. It's a 5-inch compared to the 5.5-inch 6X. So definitely clear difference in terms of dimensions there. In terms of one-handed use, 6X is a bit trickier. But luckily, while we just throw in various options in the settings in order to shrink down the display towards the bottom of the screen to make it a bit easier to use one-handed. So that's not a massive issue if you're worried about that. In terms of the general thickness and all the rest of it, they're about the same, around the sort of 8mm mark. Not much difference there. As you can see, they both have ever so slightly jutting camera lenses. Again, it's minimal at best. I certainly wouldn't concern yourself about that. And in terms of the construction of it all as well, as you see, they're both metal handsets, very similar design indeed, with this sort of top and bottom banding and all the rest of it. Volume rocker and power button on that side. On this side, you get the SIM and micro SD memory card tray. Up top, a bit of headphone jack action. And down below, of course, it's the old school USB. You don't get the new reversible type C, unfortunately, which does mean those longer data transfer speeds and all the rest of it, but nothing to concern yourself about too much. This is a budget handset after all in both cases. As for the screen, you get a full HD panel in the 5.5-inch on a 6X, whereas it's a 720p standard HD in the 6A. But of course, because the 6A is a smaller screen, it makes sort of minimal difference, really, that drop in resolution. You'll still find that images are pleasingly crisp. If you get nice and close, you'll see you'll kind of struggle to make out individual pixels on either of these phones. They're both perfectly up to the job of video and the rest of it, although of course, the 6X is a bit more spacious, so a bit more comfortable if you want to be watching a movie or lots of shows on the go, for instance. In terms of the OS, both handsets rock a bit of Android Nougat. In the case of the 6A, it's also backed by Huawei's very latest Emotion UI 5.1, which brings you all the latest awesome features. So for instance, you've got a full apps tray and all the rest of it. You've got plenty of gesture support as well, so you can fast load the camera if you so desire, all that kind of stuff. So that's all groovy, and of course a bit of knuckle modes. We all love knuckle modes. The Honor 6X, again, it's running Android Nougat. This is actually a sample device that we're rocking right now. It's not our personal device. So it's actually got Emotion UI 4.1 on it, back in the day, retro, old school and all that. But it is actually upgradable over the air to Emotion UI 5. So again, you'll be able to get full apps, tree access and all that kind of thing. So in terms of the general interface and everything, there is again minimal difference there. As for the actual processor tech, it's a Kirin 655 backed by 3 gigs of RAM in the 6X. We're really impressed by the performance. It's very, very dependable indeed, nice and smooth. Apps load up basically the instant you tap them. You're not hanging around or anything like that. It's very, very good indeed for all of that. The 6A, it has lesser tech in it. It's got Snapdragon 430 backed by just 2 gigs of RAM, but again, seems perfectly dependable. Honor's been making a lot of behind the scenes adjustments to make Emotion UI really, really nice and smooth and easy to use and all the rest of it. And it certainly seems to be doing the job. We've seen no stutters or stammers. We've only been rocking this handset for a couple of hours now, but certainly seems well up to the task. Just everyday use and all the rest of it. So you should be able to do a bit of gaming on it and all the rest as well. Stay tuned for our full review where we'll give you our in-depth thoughts, of course, on all of that. As for the storage, you get 16 gigs in this bad boy, 32 in the Honor 6X. Of course, most of the storage is taken up by the OS and pre-installed apps in the case of the 6A, whereas you get a bit of extra space in the 6X, which is always nice. But both are expandable via microSD, up to 128 gigs, I believe it is, in the 6A, and 256 in the 6X. So plenty of extra space for all your media and all the rest of it, which is good. 6A, of course, has a smaller battery than the 6X as well. It's a 3,000 20mAh cell. We haven't had a full chance to test out the battery life of this bad boy, but hopefully that should do the job for a good day and a half of use, especially because it's got a smaller, less sharp screen to power, which is always handy. And the Snapdragon 430 is generally quite energy efficient as well. 6X packs a 3,340 mAh cell, and battery life has been very, very solid on it so far. We easily get a day and a half out of use out of that, as long as we're not pounding it with Skype or anything like that. So that's definitely definitely very dependable indeed. And when it comes to fingerprint sensors, 6X has got one mounted here on the rear, and it's very, very swift and responsive. Great stuff. Unfortunately, you don't get a fingerprint sensor on the Honor 6A. It's just that little bit more basic and budget. So you're stuck with the likes of Google Smart Unlock features or a good old standard PIN or something like that if you want to be doing that. Which brings us nicely onto the camera tech. So of course you get a dual 12 and 2 megapixel lens on the 6X, which work together in order to produce nice detailed shots and a nice bit of depth processing as well. So you get some nice bokeh on your shots and all the rest of it as well. You get a more standard single lens. It's a 13 megapixel lens in this case on the 6A, both of course sporting an LED flash and all of that. Camera interface is very, very similar. If we just open them up side by side, you'll see there's very, very little difference indeed. You get the same sort of features, you get the usual filters and all the rest of it. LED flash, of course. You can swap between the front and rear cameras. You get an 8 megapixel front camera on the 6X and it's just a 5 megapixel camera on the 6A. But yeah, in terms of the general interface and the rest, they're both basically identical. Whoop, a quick swipe and you're into the video modes. As you can see, you've got full pro controls for both camera and video, which is always good on both handsets. And of course, all the usual stuff. You get a slightly bigger selection of modes on the 6X, including night shot and all that kind of stuff, but there's really not much difference in it there. And of course, you've got full settings just with another swipe. If I can get that eventually, there we go. So it just allows you to mess around with the resolution and all that kind of stuff, turn on the object tracking and things as well. You can shoot up to full HD video on both of these, and you've got a nice bit of digital image stabilization to help out when needed as well. So that in a nutshell is just a very brief side-by-side of the 6A and the 6X. Go check out our full review of the 6X and our hands-on with the 6A for more information, and we'll be providing our full 6A review very shortly. Thanks for watching, guys.